High on a hill above Lismore, in a very small kitchen, Sophia Watt is doing big things.
It's basically a chow mein base with potato gems on top and cheese on top of that.
Oh, you had me at potato gems.
The mother of three makes between 80 and 120 meals a day for flood survivors who are still doing it tough.
At night time, I fill the slow cookers with different dishes.
At first, Sophia paid for everything, but word got out, and now all the ingredients are donated. Volunteers are also chipping in, helping her cook and package meals.
I decided to do this because I hope that if I was ever in this position, that somebody would do it for me.
Each dish is photographed and posted online, where families can put in their orders.
I'm amazed that we are 3 months since that first flood, and there is still that need for people who don't have any food.
There is hundreds of homes that still only have one or two power points, so therefore they don't have a kitchen. They don't have a stove.
There's no dogs barking or birds tweeting.
When I came here soon after the first flood, every footpath in the city was piled high with rubbish. It looked like a tsunami had hit.
Today, the garbage is all gone. It looks like things are returning to normal, but looks can be deceiving. Just beneath the surface, things are far from fixed. Families are still struggling and still need the most basic of help.
Hi, how are you?
Hi, lovely to meet you, Belinda.
Nice to meet you.
I've got some very special deliveries here from Sophia.
Belinda Walker shares her home in South Lismore with her husband Mick, a daughter, and five grandkids. That's eight mouths to feed. She wishes she didn't need Sophia's help.
There is so much pressure on us just for day-to-day living. Like we've got, sorry, I may get a bit emotional.
That's all right.
We have all of the normal things to do in life, like you're cooking, you're cleaning, you're bathing children, everything. And then on top of that, we have to try and restore our house and go to work and do everything. It's been an absolute blessing because that's just one little thing that we just haven't had to worry about doing.
And here's the whole family, home from school and loving Sophia's food. What they have done is made what's left of their house into a home.
We're exhausted. And just when you don't think you've got any strength to keep going, look what you get. You get a sweet little snuggle and you just think, yeah, it's okay. It's all going to be all right. Isn't it, buddy? All going to be good.
There's an eerie feeling in these devastated streets at night. Flickering lights in faraway rooms reveal some have returned, choosing to camp out inside their homes.
90% of the people on the street haven't made it home yet. Yeah. But my neighbour's house is full of mud and she's too sad to come home.
This was Chris and Nikita's first home. A year after moving in, one-year-old Ari was born. 3 days ago, they had reason to celebrate. The power was back on.
It was quite important to get back for us, so we wanted to keep a little bit of this structure. Just, I call it camping, but...
Living conditions are basic, but it's the Ritz compared to this. On the night of the flood, the whole family and their pets took refuge inside the roof.
Yeah, we were sitting, like, with the rain hitting right above our heads under a tin roof.
To add insult to injury, a water bill has arrived from the council for nearly $2,000.
Yeah, Lismore City Council. $1,900 water bill to wash your house out.
And complicating matters even further, the scammers have moved in.
I am hearing this everywhere I go.
Yeah.
People are scamming flood victims. I mean, yeah.
It's crazy. It's wild. I've had mates myself that are just going through Service New South Wales at the moment, back and forth, proving that they actually live there, not someone else that's just taken their money.
Greg McMahon is one of the fortunate few with flood insurance, but it'll be at least a year before his house is livable. In the meantime, he and wife Vicky are making do in a caravan on the front lawn.
Careful, it might be too hot.
Greg had a kidney transplant 4 years ago.
We've had our days, we've had our cries, but it's just one day at a time.
I had to take a month off after the flood. I couldn't cope.
Yeah.
Because I have to, where I work, I try and help people through this situation, but I couldn't help someone if I can't help myself.
And what what was the toughest part for you, Greg?
Sorry, leaving the house.
Yeah.
And worrying about her.
The rebuild of Lismore's CBD is also painfully slow. Tradies are in high demand from the businesses preparing to reopen, but most shops are still boarded up, their future uncertain. This music store will be up and running soon.
Spandau Ballet, and it's yellow. That's a collector's item.
All the workers here lost their homes in the flood. But barista Crystal Bock also lost her dad, Stuart, who was washed away in the deluge.
The more I do work, the easier it kind of gets, or the better I get at managing my emotions and my feelings whilst at work.
Crystal, you're turning up here to work every single day. You're clearly putting a smile on everyone's faces. In many ways, you're kind of the face of the resilience of this community. Is that how it feels for you?
It was funny because it was said that my dad's face was the face of the flood. It's been said that by a lot of people. So it is very hard. I was brought to tears, yeah, and I actually felt like crying when you said that as well. I don't know, actually.
You're doing so great.
Thank you.
You really are. And you do a darn fine coffee as well.
Yeah.
And that is keeping the community together too.
Good.
On the final day of our visit, the clouds began to clear and Lismore was again a city in the sun. There's no denying the enormity of the task ahead, but just when it seems overwhelming, out of the blue, another truck rolls in, filled with donated winter clothes, blankets and much more.
We've got six fridges, we've got a washing machine, we've got about 30 crates of clothes, we've got about 30 crates of bed linen.
JC Young and her husband David are Brisbane accountants. They put a call out for donations because 3 months on, the need for help is far from over.
If this is the best that we can do, I don't know how we can call ourselves a first world country.
It's absolutely devastating that our community has gotten to this and that people outside of Lismore think that it's over. It's far, far from over.
I think whether we're talking about floods on the north coast of New South Wales or in Queensland or bushfires on the south coast of New South Wales, it's often the long tail of these things, which is what becomes really difficult for the communities that are there. There tends to be the media and the services and the government ministers that all rush in and provoke a huge response in the immediate aftermath, and that's when a lot of the giving happens and the food gets sent and people come up with incredible ideas and do incredible things. But I think it is as the months drag on that stuff starts to fall out of mind for those that aren't there and aren't immediately in it. And I think if you are at home and you have given before, you have helped before, it's worth circling back to 3 months, 6 months down the track to even check in with the people that you know that live in Lismore in one of those communities to see what it is that they need.
Well said. And we have an update on Chris and Nikita's outrageous $2,000 water bill. Lismore City Council will be adjusting it and about 1,400 others to reflect their water usage before the flood. A statement from the council and links to how you can help the people in our story are on our website.